Hey guys, it's Vignesh from Code Android. In this series, we'll see how to create a basic to-do list application in Android. This is a part 3 video of this series. In this video, we'll see how to add and subtask. While editing the video, I saw some mistakes, so we'll fix those first. In to-do item class, P is missing in is completed variable, so I'm adding it. In the DP handler, we are not using the table's name from constant, so I'm replacing the hardcoded table name with constants. On click of any task, we need to go to next page with subtask list. So creating an activity called item activity to display the subtask. For this activity, I need the same layout like dashboard activity. So I'm copying the content of dashboard activities layout file and pasting it here. Changing the toolbar ID as item toolbar and recycler view ID as RV item. Also renaming the fab ID as fab item. For this activity, we need to set the toolbar. So calling set support action bar by passing item toolbar. We want to enable back button for this activity. So setting set display home as app enabled as true and set home button enabled as true. These two lines will make the toolbar button as back arrow. We need to pass two datas from dashboard activity to item activity. So I'm adding two constants in our constant file called intent to do ID and intent to do name. Setting onClick listener for to-do name text view. Inside we need to start item activity. Context.startActivity. Inside we need to pass an intent. So creating an intent by passing context and item activity. We'll pass this intent object to start activity. Here we need to pass to-do ID and task name. Using putExtra, I'm adding those. I want to display the task name as the title for the item activity. So in item activity, setting the title which we are getting from the intent by passing intent to do name. On click of the toolbar back button, we need to kill our current activity. To do that, we need to override a method called onOptionsItemSelected. If the item's ID is equals to android.r.id.home, then toolbar button got pressed. Otherwise calling super.onOptionItemSelected. Here returning true and killing the activity by calling finish method. Now we'll launch the application to see the linking is working or not. Let's open the task. You can see the task name is coming as a title for the item activity. Now we need to add the subtask on click of the fab button. Setting onClick listener for the fab button, copying the content of fab dashboard and pasting it here. We need DB handler and a method for refreshing the recycler view. First, we'll create the DB handler object and initialize it inside onCreate. Instead of using addTodo method, we need to create a method for adding the subtask. So adding a new function called addToDoItem, inside taking toDoItem as parameter. Here also I am setting the return type as boolean. Like addToDo method, we need writable database and content values. So I am copying this and pasting it here. Inside content values, adding item name and toDoID. We need isCompleted as integer, so I'm checking if isCompleted is true, then putting isCompleted as 1, otherwise putting isCompleted as 0. Calling insert method by passing table toDoItem, null and content values. returning true when the result is not equals to minus 1, otherwise returning false. Adding a function called getToDoItem for getting the subtask. Here, adding ToDoId as parameter and setting its return type as mutable list of ToDoItem. To store the ToDoItem, creating a mutable list and assigning it with ArrayList. Then returning the variable as result. Here, we need to read the data and insert into list. So, I'm getting the readable database. Using raw query method, getting the records from ToDoItem table where ToDoId is equals to the ID which we are passing. After using the result, we need to close it. So, calling close on query result. If query result.moveToFirst is true, then we need to read the data. Using a do-while loop, reading all the data from the query result. Inside, creating an object of ToDoItem to store the data. Getting the ID from the query result using getLong method. Similarly, getting the item name using getString method. IsCompleted is a boolean value, so getting its integer value which is stored on the database and comparing it with 1. If the stored value is 1, then true, otherwise false. Finally, adding the item object inside the list. Now, we have completed the method for adding subtasks and getting subtasks. We need to use this addToDoItem method here. Inside, we need to pass ToDoItem object. So, creating an object of ToDoItem. Inside, setting item name which is entered on the edit text, also need to set the ToDoId. So, we need to get the ToDoId which is passed via intent. To store the ToDoId, creating a variable called ToDoId, which is a type of long. Inside onCreate, getting the ToDoId from the intent. Now, setting this ToDoId for the item. While adding a subtask, we want it to be active, so setting isCompleted as false. Creating a function called refreshList for setting the RecyclerView adapter. So, copying the adapter from dashboard activity and pasting it here. For this, we need another layout with checkbox, so creating a layout file called rvchildItem. Here also I'm changing the root layout as relative layout and changing its height as wrap content. Inside adding a checkbox with width as match parent and height as wrap content. Because I'm going to use this checkbox to display the subtask name. Adding padding as 16dp and assigning id as cb_item. In the view holder, we need to use cb_item, which is a type of checkbox. Also changing its value name as item name. In onBindViewHolder method also, I'm changing the value name. We need to pass mutable list of ToDoItem for this adapter, so getting the item name from p1thItem. Now, we need to set the checkbox status. To do that, setting the checkbox checked status as isCompleted. Changing the layout file from child-dashboard to child-item. Also, I don't want the same name for the adapter. So, I'm renaming the adapter into item adapter. Now, we need to set the adapter. Before that, setting the layout manager as linear layout manager. Setting the adapter by passing context, we need to get the list using getToDoItem by passing ToDoId. We need to call this refresh list after adding an item as well as onResume. Now we'll launch the application. Let's add a subtask. You can see it got added. Let's add another. Now we need to set the onClick listener for this subtask. Here we need to update the subtask. So I'm copying addToDo item and pasting it one more time. Renaming the function as updateToDo item and removing the return type. Here we need to call update. Inside we need to pass table name, content values, where class and string array. Passing the where class as column id and the array as item id. Here we need to call updateToDo item. So adding db handler as a parameter for the item adapter. For updateToDo item method, passing p1th item as an argument. Before that, we need to inverse the state of is completed. Now we'll launch the application. Now I'm checking the subtask 1 and going back. When we open the task again, it should preserve the state. You can see subtask 1 is still checked. I'm checking this as well. Still the state is preserved. In next tutorial, we'll see how to add a menu for the task. That's all for this video, guys. If you want to support me, you can do that by becoming a patron at patreon.com/codeandroid. Hope you like it. I will see you in my next video. Have a nice day.